Thank you very much, Dr. Austin, for that wonderful presentation. So with the next 10 or 15 minutes or so, I would like to introduce you more to the Assay Guidance Manual program. So I'm going to share my slides here. So for whoever's joining us now, I'm the I'm the editor-in-chief of the Assay Guidance Manual. Welcome again. And like I said, I would like to introduce you to assays and their importance in the drug discovery pipeline. I would like to introduce you more to the Assay Guidance Manual program, the ebook, and the workshops and the trainings that we run. And then talk to you a little bit more about this workshop's objectives and goals and today's agenda. So effective drug discovery begins with the right assay. So if you look at the drug discovery pipeline, you realize that for every drug discovery campaign, you need to always start with the right assay. And what I mean with the right assay is the assay that actually properly measures the activity of a certain target. Assays are not only utilized during this step of the pipeline, they are actually utilized throughout the pipeline, all the way from target development to preclinical development. And the Assay Guidance Manual program that we run, including the ebook and workshops, cover assays throughout all this pipeline. Assays can vary in design, in complexity and throughput. So you can have assays such as biochemical assays that are pretty low in complexity, but very high in throughput. And on the other end of the spectrum, you have assays that are high in complexity, but very low in throughput. And then you have assays in between that have pretty decent complexity, but also pretty decent throughput. So I was saying that there is a lot of different ways that we can run assays, and these assays vary tremendously when it comes to complexity and throughput. But what needs to remain constant is that all of these assays need to be robust. And the reason for that is that robust assays help prevent irreproducibility in basic and clinical research. So there was a publication published in 2015 that showed that the cumulative prevalence of irreproducible preclinical research exceeds 50%. This results in approximately $28 billion US dollars spent per year on preclinical research that is not reproducible. And the categories of preclinical irreproducibility include biological reagents and reference material, study design, data analysis and reporting, and laboratory protocols. So the Assay Guidance Manual program was created to address this problem specifically. We have a program that is a disease agnostic program, and we would like to help scientists design and implement robust assays in early translation research. Our program sets best practices and standards for assay development, implementation, and analysis. And more information about our program can be found in the manuscript published by Kust et al. In 2018 in Clinical and Translational Sciences. And the Assay Guidance Manual itself is made of about 52 chapters currently, and has over 1,300 printed pages, and they are all downloadable in a PDF format. It is a freely and publicly available resource, and it has been so since 2005. It is accessible as an ebook on the National Library of Medicine and CBI bookshelf, and this is the location you can find it. It is a dynamic ebook with continued renewal and expansion of content. And what we mean with that is we're always updating the older chapters. We're bringing in new chapters as technology evolves. It is widely accessed. So there is more than 30,000 views per month in 2020. And it is accessed by scientists from pharma, biotech, government, and academic research laboratories. We currently have 36 editors with extensive experience in preclinical assay development and drug discovery. And we do hold currently a Creative Commons attribution license, which permits copying, transmission, and adaptation of the work, provided original work is properly cited and not used for commercial purposes. So the Assay Guidance Manual has multiple sections, and each of the sections carry many chapters. The heaviest chapters are in vitro biochemical assays, in vitro cell-based assays, and assay validation operations and quality control. We keep expanding. We are bringing in new chapters to the Assay Guidance Manual by the end of this year. But also what is really exciting is that we are going to expand the Assay Guidance Manual to not only be a small molecule manual, but also manuals for biotherapeutics. And we're starting these goals by including a section in this manual that that focuses on antibody therapeutics. So keep an eye open for those exciting new chapters on antibody therapeutics coming in 2021-2022. The Assay Guidance Manual is widely accessed, as I mentioned earlier. And in the month of April 2017, as you can see in this heat map, the Assay Guidance Manual was accessed by 131 countries, which is really exciting. It is the AGM is indeed a popular resource, because it, as you can see here in this graph, that it has been accessed about 100,000 times per quarter since 2017. As I said earlier, we are not just a manual, we are a program, and we've been running these assay guidance workshops for high throughput screening and lead discovery since 2015. And as I'm showing here, this is all the most of the workshops we run so far since 2015. Many of these workshops are actually available online at this location. So anyone can freely go online and watch these recorded videos. We are also recording these current workshops, and those videos are going to be available online for you as well. In the future, we plan to run yearly virtual AGM workshops to increase our national and international visibility. We'd like to run, what we want to do, and we're very excited about, is that we will run topic-focused workshops starting 2021, and some of the topics include DNA-encoded libraries, antibody therapeutics, and many others. We're also going to conduct an AGM symposium on therapeutic repurposing and discovery for COVID-19 sometime in early 2021. And we highly encourage you to connect with us to stay tuned about upcoming workshops and symposia. So, and there's multiple ways you can connect with us. One of them, as I said earlier today, you can follow us, if you're a Twitter user, follow us at Assay Guidance. We have a LinkedIn group that you like, you can join. And we also post our events on the NCATS events website, as well as the NCATS AGM website. So with this, I would like to introduce you to today's workshop's objectives and goals. I gave an overview now of the Assay Guidance Manual ebook, and hopefully you can appreciate and discover that it is indeed an important resource for detailed information about robust assay methods and best practices in quantitative biology. We would like you to learn practical approaches for developing robust assays for biochemical, cell-based, and high-content screening, as well as the selection and development of optimal assay reagents. We would like you to get an overview on sources of assay artifacts and strategies to identify those artifacts as well. We would like to teach you about important statistical and data analysis concepts, with an emphasis on how you use these concepts to collect the best possible data and make go and no-go decisions based on experimental results. We're also going to give you an overview in this workshop on emerging technologies and new modalities in drug discovery. And these are all new talks that we have introduced, including the use of stem cells, antibody therapeutics, DNA-encoded libraries, and advances in COVID-19 therapeutics. Many of these topics we're going to expand in the later years to come with topic-focused workshops. We're also going to give you time for networking, an overview of various translational career paths, And hopefully you will have time to share your experiences and seek practical advice about individual research concerns as well. And the way you can reach out and ask questions today is through the chat box. So please feel free to type in your questions in the chat box, and we will have folks monitoring the chat box throughout all this workshop and making sure we answer all of your questions. With this, I would like to thank the NCATS leadership, including Dr. Austin, who gave us a opening note today, Dr. Anton Simeonov, who is the scientific director of the Division of Preclinical Innovation at NCATS, and he will be giving us the closing note tomorrow afternoon, and all the AGM team, including Dr. Matt Hall, Abigail Grossman, Dr. Sita Sitampalam, and Kyle Bree McCombie. And a special thanks goes to all Assay Guidance Manual editor and the Assay Guidance Workshop speakers and hosts for constantly supporting this program. So I would like now to jump in and introduce to the day one schedule. So basically we have a very diverse schedule agenda today, and I really hope you enjoy it as much as we will. And again, we have multiple breaks during the sessions here for you to ask all the questions you have. There will be virtual lunch tables. If you could not secure a spot in those roundtables, we will be recording those as well, so you could you could watch these roundtables later. And finally, we will have a happy hour at 5:30. So we'd like you to join, relax, and network there. Okay, so it's almost 9:03, so I will now introduce our next speaker, who is Dr. Yuming Wang. Dr. Wang is a principal scientist in medicine design at Pfizer, and he will be talking to us about target qualification strategies. Welcome, Yuming. The floor is yours.
Thank you, Sarah, for the nice introduction. Now, I'm going to control the WebEx and sharing my screen.